this video we'll cover Irido problem, where the what is given is there are two masses connected by a spring having spring constant K, and we have to determine up to what length we should compress it initially. Means if we compress the spring like this, this is the compressed part, means compressed position, and it has been compressed by delta from the free length. So what should be the value of delta so that when you release it after compression, when you release it, it goes up, and it goes up to a height where the lower mass also gets lifted. So that is the thing we have to find. It's very easy. We have to do it slightly in stepwise. First thing in such problem is take the initial position where your energy is stored. And the energy stored at this point of time is half k delta square. Now, first of all, in such problems, do not straight away go to the final position. First, always, please remember, always go to the free length position. First, it has to cross the free length position. So this is now the free length position where it will rise by height delta. It comes to free length. Then it further rises, say, by a certain height, small delta. And one thing you have to keep in mind is when it is rising after free length, here it is extension. So the energy which was initially half k delta square gets converted into lifting this much of height, that is mg delta plus mg small delta, that is potential energy against gravitational force. It has risen. So this energy has got converted into this potential energy work done against the gravitational force, and also energy is stored here when the spring reaches level delta above the mean position. So half k delta square. Now we have one bigger delta, one smaller delta. Smaller delta, we can easily, there is a small mass here, m. Now what will happen when the spring gets extension? Take this. Suppose I'm just showing it horizontally, same thing will be vertically. So if there is some extension, the force will be k delta on both the ends. So the k delta will be the force exerted by the spring at this end on this mass. K delta. So when this k delta is equal to mg, it is just about to be lifted, and when this k delta is greater than equal to m, greater than mg, it will lift the lower mass because its weight is mg. The force acting on the spring is mg down and k delta up. So when this is greater than mg, the lower mass will be lifted. So delta, let us take at mg upon k, the lifting. This is a critical point where the lifting will just start. So we have got the value of delta. Now only capital delta is required to be found, which is not difficult. You will just get a quadratic equation. Let me write that equation. That equation is k delta square multiplied by 2 is equal to twice mg delta plus twice mg. What is small delta? Is mg upon k. And plus, what is this? K, 2 I have multiplied, and delta is mg upon k. So m square g square upon k square. So it becomes m square g square upon k. And this becomes twice m square g square upon k. You add these two, it becomes 3 m square g square upon k. So you write here 3 m square g square upon k. This is the equation we have got. So just bring it on this side, and you can divide further by k. So delta square minus twice mg upon k delta minus 3 m square g square upon k square is equal to 0. This is a simple quadratic equation. You can write delta square minus 3 mg upon k delta plus mg अपॉन के डेल्टा माइनस 3 m² जी स्क्वायर अपॉन के स्क्वायर इज इक्वल टू जीरो. टेक डेल्टा कॉमन हेयर, डेल्टा माइनस 3 mg अपॉन के एंड प्लस टेक mg अपॉन के कॉमन, यू गेट डेल्टा माइनस 3 mg अपॉन के इज इक्वल टू जीरो. सो वी गेट डेल्टा प्लस mg अपॉन के एंड द अदर पार्ट वी गेट डेल्टा माइनस 3 mg अपॉन के इज इक्वल टू जीरो. सो दिस इज नॉट पॉसिबल, दिस इज पॉसिबल. सो डेल्टा इज 3 mg अपॉन के. सो व्हेन डेल्टा इज ग्रेटर देन 3 mg अपॉन के, द लोअर मास विल बी जस्ट लिफ्टेड. सो डू दिस प्रॉब्लम इन टू पार्ट्स ऑलवेज रिमेंबर. फर्स्ट द अप गो अप टू द इनी to the free length point and then go beyond the free length point, whether it is initial compression, initial extension, whatever it may be. If you do it in parts, then there is a less likelihood that error will happen. Next part of the problem we'll do in the next lecture.